I'm not in big four right now and really happy about it. Every single day I wake up happy and I go to work happy and it's just such a great feeling. But I still remember the misery when I was still in big four accounting. It's honestly a little scary, like, just doing this video because, like, to be very honest, when I was still in the industry, when I was still in big four accounting, there were a lot of restrictions on what I can tell you guys and what I can't tell you guys. And being like the really open person that I am, it was really difficult for me to withhold information from you guys just because of my position. And so now I just want to, I guess, give you a little insight to what it's really like being in big four accounting. And of course, I'm not in big four right now and really happy about it. Every single day I wake up happy and I go to work happy and it's just such a great feeling, but I still remember the misery when I was still in big four accounting. And so when I was in school, big four accounting was a really big thing. People all encourage you to pursue the big four career. Teachers, professors, mentors, they all tell you to go big four because it's like the ultimate thing to do and it's like the only way you can prove yourself, the only way that you can be successful. But what they don't tell you, what recruiters don't tell you, is the long hours that you put in. And it's not just busy season. Busy season, they tell you, it's only like 3 months out of the whole year. But the thing is, not every company has a 12/31 year end. So if you get a company with 12/31 year end, yes, you'll be busy for the next 3 months. But what if you get a company with an odd year end, let's say 7/31 and 11/30, like all these different dates? Not every company is the same, and companies do have different year end dates. Depending on their year end date, that determines when your busy season is. And so this is something that I think is so crucial, and a lot of recruiters just don't tell you, and they make it seem like you just have to suffer 3 months out of the whole year and you'll be free and you'll be so happy. But I mean, your schedule really depends. How busy you are, how miserable you are, really depends on your schedule. If you get a really bad schedule like I did, if you've been on like 20 clients like I did, it's just a completely different experience than someone who only has like one main client and one set busy season. That is possible, but the thing is, it's just so much luck based. You can't really anticipate what your big four career is gonna be like. And even if you have a really good year, the next year might not even be the same. Maybe your firm might lose a client, or maybe your firm or your scheduler might put you into a completely different client. So this all is just so, I guess, easily changed. What happens this year might be totally different next year and the year after, and you really have not that much control over your schedule until maybe you hit manager or above, and then that's like five years into big four, and maybe you get like a little more control over your schedule, and that kind of changes your attitude and your just work-life balance and all that. So a lot of people say 1 year of big four equals 2 to 3 years of private experience. It is true, people do look at big four experience as like pretty significant, but the thing is, you also work 2 to 3 times more than your average like private industry people. I mean, of course, it also depends on which company you're talking about. Usually startups work a lot more, 2 to 3 years of experience, because you usually work 2 to 3 times more than private industry people, and you work longer hours, higher shifts, and all that. So it all ties together. So I hope this video can give you some insight to what is big four accounting really like. I can only speak from like a beginner staff experience, because that's where I was, and that was also the point when I decided that big four is really not for me as of right now. Maybe one day I will regret my choice and go back to big four, but as of right now, I really don't think big four is for me. I hope you can get something out of this video. Again, I have a lot of perks and benefits in my info box. Be sure to check those out. Please give me a thumbs up and subscribe if you enjoy this video. I will see you next time. Bye.